All right, here we go. I've lost four in a row. Spectacular. not doing that good. I'm killing myself with interceptions. That's what I'm doing. I don't know. Kind of seems like it might be better for me just to take a sack than a interception. At least when I punt it, it will be farther down the field. I don't know. I think I get lose patience and I end up throwing the ball where I shouldn't throw it. The last game I threw a couple interceptions. It was 21-0. And then I started to actually come back. It was 21-14, and I got the ball at halftime, and then I started my interception throwing again. That's the one issue I have, is throwing stupid interceptions. I really need to stop doing it. It feels like a hard thing to do because the defenders seem to always pick it off. They got freaking receivers on their defense. It's freaking crap.
A welcome in, everyone, to another edition of the NFL and Madden.
See how this goes, I guess.
On EA Sports. On deck, we'll put a wrap on week 7 with a good matchup here tonight between the Denver Broncos and the New England Patriots. The Broncos come into play with a sub 500 record at 3-4. And it may be time to go into damage control mode now because they cannot afford to
lose. I have a better running back. I need to try to run it a bit more. Next season.
Now we'll go down to Sports Authority Field at Mile High for this matchup.
Ross is going to test the coverage this time. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24.
Oh, I hate these, how these suggestions always give you the same freaking play.
Gresham's a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. We'll go Brown.
Ah.
That time, in on the tackle. Second down here after that run play.
Hey, we go rally.
Tosses the football.
Ah.
Wagner's able to read that play and make the hit. Scrimmage, first down.
This game's chugging along. My God.
Here we go. Along, baby. Alert.
Cars back at it now. Dropping back once again. Jeremy Hill has the catch.
Things haven't changed from when I played till now. With in zone coverage, quarterbacks, offensive coordinator, and receivers. They expect a completed pass, and that's what they got in this last play.
Hills line up now as the running back behind the quarterback.
Whew.
You're running back in this league, and you pick
barely
up
got that.
And you don't fumble the football. I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
First down, offense readying for the snap. From the gun. Mercy Harvin is a multi-dimensional threat.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When he was coming out of Florida, I thought he could be an NFL running back. Now I know he's a receiver, but he can run the football and he can catch it.
Gresham's playing out of position in the backfield here. Midway through the first. Roddy White on the receiving end.
Yeah, there we go.
17. Can you believe how steady and reliable this guy is?
He is. Is it, what's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nance. Man, he pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the catch.
Here we go.
First and 10. Hill's got it on the toss.
Ah.
Wagner making the stop.
Problem is, this game's chugging along. I can't get a good run off.
Young talents on defense in the entire league.
linebacker Khalil Mack.
Well, let's see. All his level of competition in college. Did we just smash that little phrase and get rid of it? Because Khalil Mack
pass is intercepted.
There it is.
Anderson's there to take him down.
Pepper's probably going to go to the sideline telling, hey, I got such a good pair of hands at that interception that I should play some tight end. I don't know about that, but I'll tell you this. He is one good linebacker.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Austin has the catch. Miles, the one who brings him to the ground.
When you see the defensive back on the inside of a wide receiver, you have a corner route on, make sure you throw it towards the sideline, let the wide receiver outrun the defensive back, and he makes a nice catch there.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Looking long. And they can't connect. One of the top targets in the passing game today should be Jordan Reed.
And if Jordan Reed can stay healthy, I think he's an all-pro tight end. He just has excellent speed. He can really run routes, and he can catch the football no matter where you throw it.
And Cooper is able to get hold of it. Cooper's brought down at the 21.
This is one of those guys, when you talk about receivers, no matter what, he is always open. If the coverage is tight, don't worry. Throw it out there. He'll make a play.
The Broncos come out with a split backfield. And he just tosses it incomplete. Here's a look at a very dangerous defensive unit.
Well, let's go.
Second down and 10. Finds Reed. Reed's brought down after picking up 11 on this play.
Well, you guard the tight end close, and sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
Breaking huddle at the 10.
Let's go.
And the second quarter is underway with the snap. Had it for a moment, but then lost it on the hit.
Reed's one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
And that'll probably go as a drop.
When you get third and goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Stepping up to the line at the 10. Quarters formation here for the defense.
Jesus, chugging along is really annoying me at this point.
Take the points. You didn't get it done on third and goal. Get 3 points and keep momentum on your side.
The offense is back on the field here with 4th and 3 to go. The Patriots go with the dime formation here on defense.
Yeah.
Broncos turn the ball over on downs.
The Broncos go for it on 4th down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
The Patriots were moving the football the last time they had it, only to give the football away on the pick. Let's see how they do it this time.
Yeah, you know, that's a tough situation for the offense. You get a little confidence and you're moving the football, but then the turnover just changes everything. So you got to find a way to get your confidence going again.
Second down and in a very precarious spot.
I'm going to have to try to get rid of this quickly.
The Patriots lineup, split backfield. Cars back in shotgun formation. Percy Harvin with the grab.
Let me pick a few of my own plays for a bit here.
Backs to the wall on third down.
I don't know. I don't like this.
Third and nine.
No! Come on, man! I don't even get any time ever to freaking throw the ball. I'm getting tired of it.
Broncos offense getting ready to start this drive. I'm sure they're having a hard time letting go of what happened last time when they had the football across midfield and field goal range and failed to come away with any points.
Look, I like the fact that they went for it on fourth down. What I disagreed with was the play call. It was too, it didn't give the quarterback enough options, and that's why it failed.
But you still agree that they should have gone for it?
Absolutely. I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
Moving it to the other side of the field at the 49.
Well, let's go.
Now first and 10. Easy catch there. No one near him. That is how you draw it up, isn't it, Bill?
Oh, man, a quarterback loves guys that can make catches like this, and they're just so strong. They know how to zero in. They never lose concentration, and you never see him drop a pass.
The Broncos are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Gets it out for the completion.
So far, wonderful execution this drive. When you get a chance to get out of bounds, here the offensive player got the yardage, had a chance, gets out of the bounds, stops the clock. Good job by the offense.
Set up now at the 12-yard line. First down here after the completion. It's intercepted.
All right, great.
Defensive coordinator
here at the goal line again. Woohoo.
He keeps going after this offense, and Wyatt, he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
Gresham's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time.
My goodness. This match is ticking me off.
With the defense ready to pounce.
That's not what I wanted.
The Patriots at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. Dropping back now into the shotgun.
Oh my God, come on. This match is terrible. Oh my God.
Well, when there's under 2 minutes to go, good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Going for the home run.
There we go.
Oh, he made the catch. He caught it with one hand.
White's such a great athlete, and of course, you got to be a great athlete to be able to make a catch like that.
First down here. Here's the first snap after the big play. And it's a hookup with Walker.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Carr's completion percentage 70% on the day. Locked in on the football.
There you go.
Hold of it with two hands.
Good job that time by the ball carrier. Pick it up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds and stop the clock.
Carr's now completed four in a row. Snapping the football from the 28. The Patriots bring in an extra tight end for this play.
Ah.
And the ball falls incomplete.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
Second and 10. Looking across the middle. Two hands on the football and has the catch. From inside the red zone. Hills lined up as the single back. Third and 2. Complete to Harvin. Harris is there to make the stop. The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
They are, Jim. They're marching down the field, and I give all the credit to the offensive line. They are dominating the defense right now.
Breaks the plane.
There we go.
A big touchdown right there. They're almost sure to take the lead to the locker room with that score.
All touchdowns are big, man. They're all exciting. They all make you feel great. And right now, the offense, they are feeling great about what they did on that last drive.
The Broncos back deep, ready to receive. Will test the coverage. Spins out of the tackle. Still powering ahead. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Broncos just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold them to football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches look. You make mistakes on the field, they're gonna be forgiving to a point, but you gotta be smart, you gotta be efficient, and get the job done.
One half down, and both offenses still searching for answers. We've got a defensive battle on our hands, and Larry Ridley is coming up next. With this kick, the second half is underway. Murray's going to test the coverage here. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Broncos offense trots out onto the field, looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
Let's go! Red 38! Red 38!
From the shotgun. Reed with the grab.
Ah.
That's his fourth catch of the day.
The Broncos, good job that time, moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Aww.
Cooper's there to catch the ball. That's crap. A lot of heat on it. First down at the 49. Reaches out and grabs it. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up. And when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
The pass play was good for 5. Second and 5 coming up. The Broncos come out with a split backfield. From the gun. The field and intercepted.
Yeah, there we go.
Look to put points on the board.
Nicely done.
This game after the pick.
They have a chance to really change this football game entirely. If they go down and score, that puts so much pressure on the opponents. I don't think they can handle it.
Gresham's a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this.
Oh! Holy crap! Go, go, go! Yeah!
He's in the clear. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10.
Nice. Jeremy Hill. There we go.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block and a long touchdown run.
And the point after is good. The Patriots getting ready to kick it away. Austin's got it on the return. And the tackle's made right around the 32-yard line.
The Broncos offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
That's 5 receptions on the day.
Nice job at the time, but the tight end makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
The Broncos line up, split backfield. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. Fights through contact. And he is brought down at the 45-yard line.
When you pick up first downs against the defense, they will get tired. That time, nice job by the offense getting the first down, even though they're losing here in the game.
The Patriots defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. They'll go shotgun here. Jordan Reed has the reception.
It's going to him.
Second down. They hurry to the line of scrimmage.
Get ready.
Ah.
The Broncos get a first down.
Darn it.
Don't see enough of this in the NFL anymore. The outbound. Everybody's afraid to throw it. They want all those little safe dink and dunks inside. But that is a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and wide receiver.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
And darn it.
By Jordan Reed. That's a pickup of 14.
Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. Really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy? Well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch it.
After the pass play, gain 7. Second and 3 on the way.
Get ready.
He'll take the snap from the gun. Touchdown, and they cut that lead. Still more than a quarter left in the game, and with that touchdown, they're well within striking distance.
Oh, they're right there now. Now you can sit back and change what you were trying to do. You don't have to play with desperation. You got it. Now what you've done by scoring, you've made the other team have to come out and play and take some chances.
Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie.
Oh, dang it.
Taken the 1-point gimme. They went for the 2, and they are turned away. The Broncos are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
The Patriots have done a whale of a job taking their halftime lead and adding a whole lot more to it here in the third quarter.
And they're just doing everything we saw them doing the first half, just dominating the pace of play and just being more physical than the defense.
Oh.
He's got over 130 rushing yards today.
That's a nice play that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling.
This should be the last play of the quarter. Heading to the fourth.
Okay. I don't see why he would quit. He still has a shot to win this. Probably putting some subs in or something.
Phil Simms, these offenses have been held in check so far. Do you expect that to continue?
Oh, absolutely. We've seen so much here so far. In other words, defenses have kind of dominated the play, so there's no reason to think that all of a sudden these offenses are going to turn things around. And, hey, I think whichever defense comes up with the big play is the one that's going to win this game.
First down coming up.
Oh, my God. Freaking. Once again, chugging along.
Gresham is a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. Hill's taking the handoff.
That was a predictable play call here in the fourth quarter. You got a little lead, and you're trying to run the football to run out the clock, but the defense is ready and stopped it for a short game.
Second down following the run.
And the run.
Hill's got to carry once more. It'll be third down.
We ready? Wide and yay! Wide and yay! Hold on, baby! Alert! Alert! Zebra! 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 Here we go! Red 18! Red!
Third down and two. Makes the catch in the
field.
The Patriots really got it going now. They got confidence. They got momentum. They got a small lead here in the second half. And that first down, what does it do? It just gives the offensive coordinator confidence. And, of course, this quarterback, he is always ready to go.
First and goal from the eight. Anderson's got back that time in on the tackle.
Good job that time by the defense. They're down. It's in the fourth quarter. They are expecting the offense to run the football, and they stop it for a couple yards.
Coming up to the line at the seven. The defense needs a big stop here in order to give the offense a chance as we're running low on time in this one.
In his hand. Bang.
Complete. Touchdown. And that touchdown could have officially put this one out of reach.
Well, if it's not out of reach, it'll take two miracles to get back in this game by the defensive side. My gosh, they just gave up that time. They let the offense march down there and just score a touchdown that put this game out of reach.
Gonna run this one out. Miles in on the tackle. That return's good for about 19. The Broncos offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Here we go.
First down at the 17. Underneath.
Wow.
Can't find a mark that time as the pass goes incomplete. Second down. Looks like they're going to run the Wildcat.
Let's go. Red 38.
Spillers tackled down at the 17. No huddle time.
All right, same play. It's great.
Let's go.
He'll take the snap about midway through the fourth.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. We've hit the two-minute warning in the second half. Going for it on fourth down.
All right, here we go.
Go for it on fourth down. Late stages. Going deep.
Nope.
He brings it in.
You know what? Brent Grimes always gets smoked. Brent Grimes literally always gets smoked.
And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
The Broncos now will tack on the extra point. The point after is good.
Here we go. Onside kick, I'm guessing.
The Patriots prepared to return the kick. Hardman will run this one out. Just past the 20, will mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Patriots offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a
sure, why I'm even doing
well,
this play.
That last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out. They got it done.
Walker's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then.
Let's just let this clock
time,
run out.
Throws it down the field for another completion.
All right, here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank. Zebra. 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 Wide and yank.
Grisham's playing out of position in the backfield here. First down at the 40. Hill's going to secure the handle. Smith's all over the ball carrier. The Broncos will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. Second down now. Anderson's in the backfield. Single back set.
Hold on, baby. Alert! Alert! Hey.
They'll run it here. Anderson's tackled down after a gain of 5. The Broncos will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. On the way, third down. The Patriots need to get to the 50 for a first down. Anderson's going to take the handoff now.
And I ran out of bounds, too, darn it.
This decision, you're winning the game, fourth and short, you're near midfield. I don't think you go for it. Don't let the pressure of the fans or your players get into your mind. Put the football away. That's the right decision.
Austin's going to look for space now. Miles there that time for the tackle. So the offense gets the football back here.
Definitely got to get Brent Grimes some safety help because he cannot man cover with crap.
Yeah, it does. And you know, when you're in a situation like this on the offensive side, you can be conservative. Why? You have four downs. Makes it really tough for the defense to try to stop all four of those downs.
First down. Pressure on every snap now. Second down, late in the fourth quarter. The Patriots defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Wants to go deep.
Boom!
And it's picked off by Rogers. Cromartie.
The Patriots thrilled with the interception, and the fact is this game is all but in the books.
Well, you talk about this defense.
All right, there we go.
They are not afraid to take a chance. That time they took the chance, and they came up with the big interception.
Hills handed the football. Shakes off the tackle.
Yeah!
And it's a touchdown! The waiting moments! This should all but give them the win!
Now he quits. Bye-bye. There we go. See you later, punk. Alright, there we go. I'm glad I have a good running back.